This is the Mercedes-Benz EQC, which is the brand's very first electric car, now on sale in Singapore. It's pretty good. We have a review out on carbuyer.com.sg if you want to know more. But we have driven quite a few EVs by now, and we find them a little bit samey, a little bit boring. But here we have something that is faster than a Tesla in a straight line, considerably cheaper and a lot more interesting because it's Singapore's very first production performance electric motorcycle, the Energica SS. You're probably wondering who Energica is. Well, it's an Italian manufacturer of electric motorcycles, and their claim to fame is that they actually make the standard bikes that run in the Moto E, that's the electric Moto GP category. So that's some sporting pedigree already right there. This particular model is the SS, but there's also the Ego Plus, which is a sport bike that goes for around 80,000 Singapore dollars. There's also the High Performance Naked, which is the Rebel, which means rebel in Singaporean, in English. The Rebel, that's at about 74 grand on the road. This SS 9 Plus is the only model for now. It has 109 horsepower. It retails for 64,000 Singapore dollars on the road. So that's with Siri road tax, no insurance. So as you can see from the round headlight, the SS is what they call a classic looking motorcycle. Energica calls it slightly retro, but not really. It just looks like a modern, how do you say, naked motorcycle, non-performance. So this bike has 109 horsepower, but the kicker here is from the motor, you get 200 Newton meters of torque, which is really quite a lot. So like an electric car, plenty of torque, plenty of punch. We'll get into our riding impressions later on with our test rider in a bit. But to talk more about the bike, I almost said car, the electric bike, very, very new thing. To talk more about the bike, this has a 21 kilowatt hour battery. Effective is about 18 point something kilowatt hours. Energica claims a range of 400 kilometers on one charge. DC fast charging at 20 kilowatts means you can get about 80% of the battery in around half an hour or a little bit more. Normal charging at 3 kilowatts will take you about 7 to 8 hours, which is overnight. Okay, so let's take a closer look at the bike. Obviously, Italian Energica, it's you look at the price, you know that this is a premium product. Also because it's an electric bike, just like electric car, a little bit more expensive than your standard motorcycle. But at least the quality of the components and all looks pretty top-notch from where I'm standing. Okay, LED headlight, cooling fins here. We have Brembo brakes. These are radio brakes, also seen on normal high-performance models as well. Tubular steel frame looks pretty standard for an Italian motorcycle until you get behind the frame. Huge-ass battery pack right there. This is Energica's 21 kilowatt-hour battery pack. And of course, the motor is just here and attached by a chain to the rear wheel. Very nice, what do you call it, rear sets as well. Standard, this is a Biturbo shock. So all the components, pretty high quality. You're not getting shortchanged for the money. And of course, I said that this bike is actually faster than the Tesla. What did I mean? 0 to 100 in 3 seconds flat. And the Tesla Model 3 high performance with dual motors does that in 3.3 seconds. So quite quick in and around town. Okay, one of the benefits of an electric motorcycle is actually one of the things that people are really afraid of, manual gearbox. Because you're an electric bike, you have no gearbox, you have no clutch, and I have no gear shifter. So in that sense, as a rider, I think if I just rode the bike like a twist and go like a scooter, you could actually pay more attention to the road. You don't have to worry about what your left foot is doing, what your left hand is doing. So quite useful right there. And coming closer, we'll have a look at the screen. So this screen, I don't know how big it is, but it's pretty small. Very Italian, tiny little display right there. And also, if you look here, there's also quite a nice touch. There's a light up sequence. You know, ambient lighting is coming to everything. Ooh, that's exciting. Looks like a Necron. Wow, kids, destroy your life. Okay, electric bike, you're wondering where the charger is? Here it is. Ooh. Okay, so we have our standard CCS2 plug. This is the normal charger, and this is obviously the fast charger when you plug in both. We'll do a demonstration of that in a bit. But the cool thing here is that according to my sums, to travel 100 kilometers, the fuel for this would only take about 1.065 Singapore dollars. Compare that to an everyday efficient scooter like the Honda Forza 300. $7.632 to travel the same distance. So just like an EV, you're getting quite a bit of savings when it comes to fueling the thing. Okay, you guys are probably wondering what the bike is like to ride, and we had our crack rider, Deyna Chia, ride the bike, who's going to tell you all about it. How is it, DC?
Well, this EV bike is honestly the first bike I've ridden that's an EV, and I'm actually very pleasantly surprised. It feels in terms of rideability like a regular bike. It's so quiet that you actually hear the tires, you know, roar on the floor, especially if you go over rough terrain, rough tarmac.
Hey, but just now when you rode in, I actually heard this like whine coming from the bike.
Yeah, and it's got this this Moto Gear whine that could drive some people mad. But I realized that about 100 km per hour, you really don't hear it anymore because the wind noise gets in.
Right.
And I was wearing earplugs, so then you know it anyways a lot of the unnecessary noise. But
how does it handle? I mean, like,
It's 365 kilos. The battery weighs 200 kilograms, so it's not light.
Okay.
But as you can see, the weight of the battery is pretty down low. Upon taking the bike, I went straight to South Buena Vista Road to see how the bike would handle around
for scientific purposes.
For scientific purposes at reasonable speeds.
Yeah, of course.
And it handled well.
Right.
For a bike of this weight, it would not stand the bike up if it went off throttle. It wouldn't stand the bike up if I hit the brakes. It would continue to hold a lean quite nicely. I did leave the traffic a bit far behind, much to my own surprise.
As any bike should, right?
As any bike should. I also went up to Kenridge Park, and then I came down with the brake, the engine brake left in low, and it was sufficient to get the bike down, you know, very safely.
So can you adjust that while you're riding, the engine brake?
Yes, you can adjust from off, low, medium, and high.
Okay, so just like an EV?
Just like a regular EV. And obviously like a regular EV, the higher your speed, the more the engine brake or the more the motor brake.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
So also really quite nice.
How far do you think you could go in real life?
Yeah. So there are four modes to this. There's Eco, Urban, Rain, as well as Sport. In Eco mode, it limits the top speed to 92 km per hour. And it kind of limits your consumption to about 9.5 kilowatts per 100 kilometers at the max.
Okay.
Cruising along with a regular throttle, you probably get 8.5 kilowatts per 100 kilometers.
So that's about 8.5.
That would translate to about 250 kilometers on this bike.
Okay. Pretty good.
And if you ride in a spirited way, you get down to about 200 kilometers for a full charge.
So better than some of those loud, proud sports bikes on it. I remember you used to get 150 on.
Yeah, certain Italian other bikes do about 150, 140 kilometers before it runs dry. And then you need to push.
Cool.
So I think there's no worry about range anxiety. The only thing is because they have a percentage of charge left on your screen all the time, so that kind of gives you that, you know, that mental reminder to keep it charged.
Right, back of mind,
you know that this bike will do about 200 kilometers, you know, with spirited riding.
Cool. All right. Yeah, thanks, DC, for your riding impressions. So very pleasantly surprised he is. And this is the Energica EsseEsse9 Plus, Singapore's first performance electric bike. If you like this video, please like it, share it, subscribe to carbuyer.com.sg. Stay tuned.